Good morning, guys.
It is early, especially for Alec. It is only 8:20 in the morning, and we have arrived early for our tour. I know I'm acting weird. Anyway, we have a tour where we're going to be doing an intense thing with the cliff dwellers, but we found another place that's a self-guided tour. Since we're here early, we're going to try check that out. This is supposed to be the biggest of the cliff dwellings, so we'll get some video there.
It's kind of funny, there it is. And I didn't realize, but I learned about this in elementary history class. And it's the exact one that was in my my textbooks. Now I get to visit it. That's pretty cool. Oh wow.
Oh wow. We go to come here.
The house is right over there. It's closed. We would have paid $30 to get into this park. We have the National Parks Pass, so we got in here for free. But you would have paid $30 to get in here to find out that the best preserved place that you can go, best
it's
preserved
closed.
House, is
It's
closed.
closed.
Wow. That's sad.
It is sad.
So we just talked to one of the rangers, and they said that the cliff dwelling house. One of them, the, what was
spruce
it,
tree.
Spruce
yeah, it's
Tree.
Been closed for over a year, almost a year.
Almost
it's
a year.
Closed for 2 more years.
For another 2 years because of hazardous rocks. So that's just fantastic. This is the pit house. This was 600 AD. What was that? That was like the main room. Was that storage over here?
I think they said one was an antechamber and one was the main room.
I see. So this is their main living area here. They dug holes and lined it with rock and put food in it to preserve the food. And then that was, they suspect, storage over there. The square tower house.
It has at least 60 rooms inside of there. Can
really?
You believe that?
Well, when was it made?
This is.
Does it not say? It doesn't,
it doesn't say.
No, it doesn't say.
But it is old. So that's all we know. We're going to see some pit houses and pueblos. It's from 700 AD to 950 AD. This is roughly the same as the last pit house we were at. It's a little different. You can see actually right there, there's a grinding stone they use for grinding corn. This is another kiva,
yep,
or ceremonial house.
And this one would have been flat with the ground, they said.
Yep.
The roof would have been flat.
Roof just straight across. And you can see that the architecture's changing. They're getting more, I guess, skilled with how they build, and how you can see the ventilation shaft there is really square, and the stone there is very square instead of kind of just finding a stone and shoving it in the ground.
And the stonework is very precise.
Yeah. There's a few more buildings over here. I don't know what is this thing over here? Doesn't say, does it? It's a thing though. And then this over here are a few more houses. This building here used to look like that, this one right here. I guess this is kind of like a little village over here. They say that they took some of the stones out of all these buildings to build some of the other later structures, supposedly, so that's why there's not a whole lot left of any of this stuff. But you can see that it looks like there's another ceremonial room over there. Not sure. It's pretty cool though. The fire temple, right there. Also over here is I'm assuming part, still part of it. I really have no idea.
Yeah, they think they never lived here. This was all just for ceremony.
You can see it's pretty elaborate. I can't imagine what it looked like when, you know, back then. Because it's really falling apart now. Just look at those places. I guess this is the Sun Temple. This is 1250 AD. You can really see they got elaborate. They made some sort of cement that they kind of poured down along the sides here. Basically created a gutter and puked out right there. Their brickwork is really nice. So this is what the floor plan of this place looked like, but I guess they never finished it. There's no remnants of any roof or anything in it. So they kind of built it, something happened, and never finished. Kind of sad.
Here we are, Balcony House. We're down at the spring where they would have collected their water. I don't know if you can see it, but the bees really like it. They're down here getting their drink. So we're getting ready to climb up the ladder. We just waited to be the last ones up the ladder because there's just like a bunch of people here with kids and everything else, and it's gonna take forever. So we're hiding away from the sun. So. Okay, Alec, you ready?
Yes, I am.
Looks like Mom's on her way. This is about a 30-foot ladder we're going up. Here we go. You're doing good, Lori. Up, up, up. Here we go. Oh, they cut steps in here. Well, that's pretty nice. I don't know. Wouldn't doubt it. Check that out. Look, Alec, how they put rocks in the mortar to help stiffen it up, to wedge the rocks together.
That's amazing.
So it's time to change my glasses, huh? So I can see.
Wow. This is amazing.
Isn't it?
And you have to remember, though, the people back then were shorter than the people today.
Yes. And much skinnier.
Yep.
Probably weren't a whole lot of fat Indians. There's a hole that goes through the floor right there.
What is it?
There's a hole that goes straight down there.
That's about as fine a masonry as you can imagine. Those are done with stone tools. The ones next to it, to me, don't look quite as good, but different generations.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't all done at once. Then the famous things when you move in, there's a major remodeling project on that wall. Does anybody see this?
You can see pretty much straight out of here.
Most people are noticing. They had a regular sized doorway for them.
there's actually steps in here. Oh, wow. See, they stabilized this with metal back in 1919, I think they said. These are original pieces of wood right here. See, they cored them right there. You can see the soot stain on the roof there where there was a two-story room there. I don't know if you can see the imprint of the walls around there. But that's how high that was, went all the way up there. That's about, 12, 15 feet deep. Mm-hmm. You want to back up and fall in, huh? Look at this original piece of wood. It's hard to believe it's from 1250.
I know.
I mean, you can see the metal reinforcement that they did back in the 1920s. Here's another room.
Can you imagine being there in the winter?
See all the soot on the ceiling and everything? I don't know if the GoPro can pick it up or not. But
I don't know if it can. So
this is a defensive position. That's the reason why they blocked this off.
You can't really see too well.
Oh, and there's where the angle down with the throwing arrow coming out.
Yeah.
Oh,
right.
No, I don't think so. I mean, they probably had handholds to go up through this way, but they just enlarged them. They weren't cut out like this. Okay, we just got done with Balcony House. And what'd you guys think?
Pretty cool.
Yeah, it is really cool.
Amazing what they were able to do back then.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I can't imagine building something there.
So you have to haul up all that material up that mountain.
Uh-huh. That's for sure. Okay, well, let's go have some lunch.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's about, I would say in the 80s by now, wouldn't you?
Yep.
So let's go find some shade and have some lunch.
For lunch today, we have the honey chicken and bacon. Cheese, mayonnaise, sandwiches. That's right. And she has a nasty avocado sandwich.
How dare you say that?
It's gross, man.
Wait till I take a taste.
So gross.
Mmm.
How bad is it?
Delicious.
Delicious. Got our fancy serving napkins here. So fancy. Look at that. Pony Express Coffee Shop. No, sorry. It's the Pony Express. Oh. You see that? I see what they did there. Oh, so funny. We're at 10,133 feet.
Yep, going over Ophir, I think it's called Ophir Pass.
Is that German?
I don't know. It's in Colorado. We're taking this pass from the town of Ophir over towards Silverton.
How far away is Silverton?
They say that this is 12 mile pass.
12 mile pass. It is currently 77 degrees outside. It's beautiful. Yep. There's some traffic on this pass, but not a whole lot.
Yep, not a ton.
Here's kind of a view of what we're looking at on this pass.
This is 11,000 feet now.
Yeah, it's pretty spectacular. It's just not as spectacular, I would say, as the place we went four-laning.
Canyonlands.
Canyonlands, yes, 2 days ago. Look at this. There's a rock field. There's a rock field.
Rock is about a, let's see,
degree incline, yeah.
Can't tell from the ball.
And the ball is very inaccurate.
Yeah.
It's like,
it's probably 20 degrees, 30 degrees.
It's really bumpy.
Maybe
here.
Maybe 30. Here, let me stop.
I'll stop, okay. Okay, let's get a look at this.
I'd say 30.
If it'll focus. Is it just not going to focus? Come on, man. There we go.
Yeah, back up maybe. Maybe okay. Almost 30 degrees.
Maybe.
On this.
We're going over there.
Thing here.
My, this is freaky, man.
It's locker time.
This is some loose ass gravel here.
Okay, how are we on your side out? What do we got for clearance on the right?
We have about 3 feet on my side.
Rear locker.
But look at that scenery.
Don't you love the locker?
Oh, I love the rocker.
We would have gotten over that without the locker.
No, you wouldn't. And then you would have to try to back down the rest of the way.
That
would
have been funny, huh?
Oh, that would have been great.
Now, this is pretty. I thought the other one was pretty intense, but this is
Really intense.
Really intense.
Wow. Okay, so we just realized that if someone were to come down that way, there's no way that they're going to be able to pass because no. We're all the way on that side. And look how much room we have on this side. About 3 feet.
And I wouldn't even get to the right because it came in.
Yeah, it looks very loose. Yeah. Very loose. But it's all worth it because you get to see that.
Yeah.
We found snow in July, that's right.
End of July. Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's pretty awesome. It's pretty weird, the terrain. It's like just pure rock. It's like they came up with a dozer or something and just crushed all this rock and it just fell down. There's no vegetation up here.
You're supposed to ice break out, like where it just freezes up here and it just blows the stuff apart.
Yeah, and it just gets, the water gets in between the rock and it just breaks it apart.
I mean, some of that rock's green, isn't it?
Yeah, it is kind of green.
Yeah.
I wonder why it's green. Is that like a lichen?
Lichen
or something?
On it or something, yeah.
Huh. Here's the summit. Elevation 11,789 feet. Well, you could go up higher, but this is the summit of the peak here.
Yep, of this pass. So
got some people passing
on the pass.
On the pass. Would you look at that?
Yeah, look at that.
Here's near the top of the pass coming down. It's very windy up here. Cool, windy and cool. It's beautiful. It's kind of meadowy up here. A few trees. So we saw these sticking out of the ground. And we saw this here. It's like a cave and water's coming out of it. So we're like, that's kind of weird. And it's been recently buried in here. If you look at it, we think this looks like rail car, probably an ore car, tracks that came out of this. I think this is an old mine that was filled in. Let's go up and look at it. It's gonna be hard to look in there, but you can see where it tapers off the dirt where they filled it in. This is an old mine. That is really cool. Wow. Just up here on a Forest Service road. This is Silverton off of the pass. It's a very touristy town.
Yeah, but it's cool.
But it is a very cool town. People just drive their side-by-sides down there. Ooh, there's an arcade.
Old arcade, it says.
We're gonna have to check that out. It is pretty cool. Here we go. Here's where we're camping. Right across from a little stream.
This is a lovely spot.
Yeah, now I'm gonna get a fire going, but the problem is there's not much wood around. It's basically just grass and little shrubs. So it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be great. So what do we got going over here?
Alex's mad skills. He started a fire with one napkin.
Two napkins.
Yes.
And what's the temperature out here right now, Lori?
It's probably 58 now.
Yep. When we pulled in, it was 61 and the sun was up, but it's getting cold now. And we're just north of Silverton, about maybe 6 or 7 miles in the forest. So, I don't know if Alec filmed our campsite yet, but this is our campsite. We're unfortunately right by a road, which is right up there, so you can hear some traffic on it. But there's a creek right down by us, so hopefully that'll drown out most of the road noise for the evening. So, anyway, we're gonna roast probably some wieners. What do you think, Alec? Wieners?
Sounds good.
Yeah, maybe some.
I love me a good hot wiener.
Right in your mouth.
We don't have any buns, though.
We got that French bread, though. That'll be good.
We do have bread.
Yeah. So.
Oh, sorry. I didn't even use all of the two napkins.
Yeah, look at that.
Wow. Skills right there.
That's it.
It's food time. That's right.
Chicken
we got
thighs.
Chicken thighs. Chicken thighs.
Over an open fire.
Open fire. That's right.
With some barbecue sauce after he cooks. Come on.
That's pretty sweet.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have some hot dogs. Oh, your chicken kind of fell down, Dad. On the hook, see it? Or on the post?
Okay, yeah. I'd rather have it down farther than falling in the fire.
Yeah, that is a good thing. Mmm, look at that shish kebab. Oh, man.
It looks good, doesn't it?
Chicken and barbecue sauce. Ooh.
Look at this awesome fire we got going. I mean, this is just fantastic, the heat coming off of it, and it's so cold right now outside.
And the best part is we can sit super close to it.
Yeah, 1 foot.
Because there's like no wind tonight. So you can just sit and absorb the heat coming off of this fire.
The flame's just going straight.
Straight up.
It's like the ideal campfire, like all the pictures of the perfect campfire you can get. It just goes straight up.
Yeah, it's just awesome.
Yeah.
But anyways, we're going to let this fire burn down, and then we're going to pour it out with some water.
And go to bed.
And then go to bed.
Yeah.
Because what time is it?
Let's see. What time
is it? It's not too late.
Yeah, it's only 9 o'clock.
9 o'clock, right? Okay. Maybe stay up for another hour and a half. I don't know, two hours, depending on how long it takes.
Well, once it starts getting, the fire burns down and it starts getting cold, we're going to bed. I'm not staying out here.
Oh, what temperature is it?
It's in the mid-40s.
Oh, it's mid-40s,
yeah. I can't imagine what it's like here in Colorado in the winter because it's ridiculously cold in July.